back, probably the best two teams on campus. Defending champion Def Jam, who will be wearing gold, versus Mo Hop, a team full of good athletes. As I've been corrected by official Bobby McWard, Mo Hop won the tournament last year, but we'll go with Def Jam as the defending champions because they won the league. And that's a quick pass from Ted Taylor down low to Dylan Johnson. That's a quick 2-0 lead for Mo Hop. Different than the one you saw earlier. These two teams are without weak links. They are strong all the way from A to Z. Johnson rebounds and kicks the ball out to Derek Avery with the two, and we have a 4-2 ball game early on. Avery to Taylor. High off the glass. And the track meet has started. Right back comes Def Jam. Charlo to Sadie. We have a kick by Avery. Murray controls up top. Three-pointer by Carlos Charlo. Johnson banks one. They have a loose ball foul. On Derek Avery. Oh, that was my mistake early on the shot. It was Derek Hayes. Well, Avery is number 42. Derek Hayes is number 4. That foul will be on Dylan Johnson, his first. Dacus inbounds the ball. Murray controls out top once again. Adrian Sadie fires a miss. Dacus follows it up. Avery somehow controls the loose ball and he'll reset up top. Correction, Hayes. The two Derricks are giving me problems in the early going. Johnson, good up and under. Thanks to miss. And Hayes controls out top once again. Quick first step by Hayes. Good baseline move. No call underneath. Johnson controls. He misses brother Dylan underneath. Push out front by Carlos Charlo. Ted Taylor to Hayes. Good block by Robert Holder underneath. Derek Hayes converts to give his team a 10-5 lead. Correct on the last factor. That was Derek Avery. I'll get it right sooner or later. Avery number 42, Hayes number 4. Hayes controlling the ball now into Avery in the post. Oh, second, making the score 10-6 with 10.5 minutes left in the first half. Tim Howard turns the ball over. We'll have an official timeout to retrieve the basketball, which is rolled onto another court. Ball movement by Def Jam. Foul on called on Robert Holder. And in comes Kwame Evans with Ted Taylor. Two people I played with. I attended Tulane many moons ago. Heads up play by Charlo. Charlo for three misses. Good rebound by Jacobs. Marquez to Stady, underneath, good defense by Howard. Here comes Johnson. And we have an offensive foul called on Dylan Johnson. Will Johnson checks in for Mo Hop, and Lance Murray checks back in for Def Jam. Actually, Johnson didn't come in. So just have Murray. Good block by Kwame Evans. Oh, they caught Seth Johnson with the walk. It was a relatively easy call despite the complaints by Mohawk. For Howard. For Mohawk. Score is 10-6 at the 8-minute mark. Stady hits a three. He has 5 in the ball game, making the score 10-9 in favor of Mohawk, the team in red. Called on Holder underneath. That's Holder's second.
Oh, it's only 2 on him.
Foul on Stady. He came against Crossyard. He'll try to sell his call, but I think deep down he knows that he grabbed the man's arm. That'll send Seth Johnson to the line to shoot 2. No basket, violation on the shooter. He stepped over the line before the ball hit the rim. Shooter must stay behind the line until the ball hits the rim. Dacus checks in for Holder for Def Jam, and Willie Johnson checks in for the first time for Mo Hop. Marquez, for 3, back rims it. Johnson controls, beneath to Evans, and he just lost the ball. Thank you. substituting going on right now. Both teams search for the right combination to make a good run. Ted Taylor checks in for Johnson. Dacus from about 18 feet hit. To tie the score at 11 all. 5.5 minutes left in the first half. In the backcourt for Mohawk, you have to get that reset for you. You have Hayes and Evans in the backcourt with Taylor, Johnson, and Avery up front. Ted Taylor misses the bank. Lance Murray wanted to get the ball down to Charlotte, but instead he hits Marquez. Gets the three. And you have a timeout call with 4:44 left in the half. Def Jam up by 5 points, 16-11. As we return to action, the score is 16-11 in favor of Def Jam, the team in goal, with 4:44 left after the timeout. Tess Johnson back in the game for Mohawk, controls the ball up top. Swings it over to Hayes. Avery misses the runner in the lane. Marquez clears, and boy, is he quick down the floor. Lance Murray misses underneath, but he follows his own shot and misses again. And Hayes clears once again. He feeds the ball to Dylan Johnson. Dacus wanted a push off there. He didn't get the call. That was a big league shot by Adrian Stady. His second three of the game, giving him 8 for the half. The 3-point play and put his team up by 5 points. about a minute left. We're at a 24-19 ball game. Taylor underneath to Johnson. Air balls, a good defense by Holder. Dacus to Marquez off the glass. Def Jam starting to open things up a bit. Under a minute. Dacus underneath, and that'll put Dylan Johnson to the line. Shoot two. 39.8 left. Very close to a lane violation on Seth Johnson stepping out after the ref released the ball, but fortunately for Mo Hops, it wasn't called. Dylan misses both of them. There's a foul on Derek Hayes. Oh, correction, that was not a foul. But merely some sort of violation. Holder hits his first two of the game. So with 24 seconds left, in all likelihood, Mo Hops will hold out for the last shot. Hayes calls off Avery's pick. And with 10 seconds left, they go into their offense. Actually, they wait a little bit longer. Good defense by Def Jam. And we'll end the half with the score. Def Jam, 28, 19 for Mo Hops. Okay, we return to action with the score 28-19 in favor of Def Jam, the team in the gold jerseys. The refs check with the clock. We have a new ref this game, Nick Iyengar. Lance Murray hit. Nick has changed his shorts. I don't know if you had a chance to note his shorts early on. They were tan, but he has converted to the traditional black shorts of the intramural referees. Johnson misses. Both teams looking to run in the early going here of the second half. That's Taylor's shot. He misses this time. Lance Murray with the rebound. Dacus helps out bringing the ball up court, and they get the ball in the hands of Stady. Good dish off by Stady to Dacus. And right now, Mo Hops really is going to have to, they're going to have to close the gap here. Avery sticks out the old hip catch Dacus. I don't think Mo Hops can afford right now to run with Def Jam. They need to go ahead and play a slightly slower style of game. There was the pick and roll by Murray to Holder, a la Stockton to Malone. Okay. And it will result in a two-shot foul. Holder goes in line for two and checks Kwame Evans, number 23. Mo Hop. So the gap is growing larger now. And Mo Hop really needs a basket on this possession. Good hustle by Ted Taylor, but he couldn't save the ball. run. Johnson was looking to slow it down. The blocking foul underneath on Rashard Dakin. Taylor rims out. Marquez controls the rebound. Whoa, good move. Took it straight through the hole on Hayes. Hayes makes his argument, but that was a fairly easy call. The man announcing the game on the side can see it. It's a fairly easy call. And I could see it clearly from where I was sitting. So Marquez will shoot too. Is 10 points in the game. Number 23 for Def Jam. Foul across the arm on Dakin. He whacks Evans as Evans blew to the hole. Charlo tried desperately to get in, but we'll have to wait. Have to wait a whistle. Ted Taylor, good rebound. Evans finally knocked the lid off the basket. Substitutions going on. Rebound by Howard. He almost took off Palme's Evan Ted going for that rebound, but just comes out with the ball. Hayes convert. Good move by Charlo. Better pass by Charlo to Robert Holder. So it's a 17-point lead now for Def Jam. Charlo's going to hear about that one. He left it short on the front of the rim, blew the dunk. But you can afford to do that when you have a 17-point lead. Lance Murray looks like he just got hit with a technical. They have a personal foul and a technical foul on Murray. This is a good chance for Mo Hop to dig into the lead. They're going to be shooting four free throws here. They have potential to make up 6 points on this possession. Potential to make up 7 points. Lance Murray's in disbelief. Thank you. doesn't. They run straight through. The only time the clock stops are on timeout by either team or official and on every whistle in the last minute of either half. Big clumsy Warner Saunders is about to check in.
Yeah, I'm in.
A little late arriving, but he could provide a strong inside force. And Otis lands it down. Warner is another person I used to play with back in my Tulane days. He will be checking in with Ted Taylor. Wholesale changes going on here for Mohawk. To a bloodbath. Mo Hops is really going to have to make a run right here. We're at 6.5 minutes, so if they're going to make a run, they have to make it now. That last dunk by Marquez. Really impressive. He can't be any taller than 5'9". So he can really fly. Lance Murray from way deep. That was just about NBA range. A holder follows. So the score is now 49-26 in favor of Def Jam. Def Jam right now are playing like defending champions. Def Jam's playing like a team that has something that they cherish greatly, being a championship, and they're not going to surrender.
What number?
With a timeout called by Warner Saunders, with a score of 51-26 in favor of Def Jam. Turn to action after the timeout by Mo Hop. Score 51-26. Mohawk isn't out of the game yet, but they have to convert, and they have to reduce the careless turnovers that have cost them. Dylan Johnson hits. That was a two-point shot put on the line. Right now, they just need to play good defense. The advantage that they'll have, they being Mo Hops, is that Def Jam in all likelihood will not hold the ball out. They'll continue to play. So they should have the opportunities on possession. They'll have to play good defense and smart offense. Johnson scores again. They trail by 23 points with Mo Hops. On the next foul, Def Jam will be shooting 1-1. Dacus on Johnson. Good up and under. Blocked by Saunders. point. Sadie over to Holder. Pushes the ball back to Murray up top. Holder has had a big game. He has 13 points. Ramon Marquez checks back in for Lance Murray. Talked to Ramon at the break. He says he's 5'10", so I don't want to shortchange a man an inch, but nonetheless, for a man 5'10", the dunk is impressive, especially when you have men who are 6 feet tall who can't dunk, like yours truly. Johnson checks in for Avery. So 2.5 minutes, Def Jam has things well under control, leading by 20 points. They are showing no signs of letting up. Winner being Def Jam, they're up by 23 points with 20 seconds left. shooting a 1-1. So Def Jam will be the number one seed in the Spring League, which is not single elimination. It's a round robin style league put on. You play teams in your division, and the champions from each division, and wild card teams, depending on your placement in each division, goes on to the playoffs. Divisions being men's campus, fraternity, co-rec, and women's. Vegas let one fly. I think that was supposed to be an alley-oop for Charlotte, but fell far short. And with 2 seconds left, this will do it. So Def Jam has once again reasserted their claim as the best team on campus by defeating Mohawk 65-40.